This video is based on bacteria foraging optimization algorithm and it is inspired by Nature. So this is a Nature inspired optimization algorithm. Here, this algorithm is basically inspired by the foraging behavior of Escherichia coli bacteria that is also known as E. coli bacteria. And we can use this algorithm to solve various engineering problems and complex real world optimization problems. As this algorithm is inspired by the foraging behavior of E. coli bacteria, so first we will discuss certain points about this bacteria. It is a type of bacteria that normally lives in our intestine, and it is also found in the gut of some animals. Most of the E. coli bacteria are harmless and they keep our digestive tract healthy, but some can cause diarrhea if you eat contaminated food or drink. This bacteria is mainly associated with food poisoning, and around 75 to 95% UTI is caused by this bacteria. Here we have certain symptoms that are caused by this bacteria, for example, vomiting, abdominal cramp, bloody diarrhea, kidney failures, confusion, fever, and many more. So this algorithm is inspired by the foraging behavior of E. coli bacteria. Now we will discuss the key idea of this algorithm, that how this algorithm is inspired by this bacteria and how it is working. So basically, it is inspired by group of foraging strategy of a swarm of E. coli bacteria. Here we have a swarm of E. coli bacteria, and this algorithm is inspired by the group foraging strategy that is used by a swarm of E. coli bacteria. As we human need food for energy like that, here a swarm of E. coli bacteria is searching for the nutrients in manner to maximize the energy so that they can survive. So this algorithm is inspired by the foraging strategy that is used by a swarm of, or you can say a group of, E. coli bacteria. They are searching for the nutrients in the search space in order to maximize their energy so that they can survive. Here, bacteria can communicate with each other by sending signals. As in the real world, we have real bacteria. Now, in this algorithm, we will assume virtual bacteria. Instead of real bacteria, we will use here virtual bacteria, and this algorithm mimics the chemotactic movement of virtual bacteria in the search space. So first we have chemotaxis. This step will provide local search for this algorithm. As we know that bacteria are moving in the search space and they are searching for the nutrients. Here, in this step, bacteria move by taking small steps while they are searching for the nutrients. As we human can run, we can walk, we can jump. Like that, bacteria can swim or tumble. So this process simulates the movement of E. coli cell through swimming or tumbling. So we have the movement for the bacteria, that is swimming and tumbling. In swimming, bacteria can swim for a long period in the same direction, and in tumble movement, we have a random walk that is in the random direction. So unit walk is done in the random direction in tumble movement. As you can see here, swimming is in clockwise direction, and here we have tumble movement that is counterclockwise rotation. As in the real world, they can move, they can swim, they can tumble, but now in this algorithm we will use mathematical equation for the movement of the bacteria. So we can compute the movement for the bacteria using this equation. Here, this is the ith bacteria at the jth chemotactic, kth reproduction at the lth elimination dispersal step, and this represents the direction vector. Here, this is the step size that is taken by bacteria in the random direction as specified by the tumble. And for the randomness, we will use the normally distributed random values within the domain -1 and 1. Next process is forming. That is the group behavior. A group of E. coli cells arrange themselves in a traveling ring. Cell-to-cell signaling of this bacteria is represented by this equation here. This is the objective function value. Here we have certain coefficient. Here S is the total number of bacteria in the search space, and P is the total number of variables to be optimized. Next we have reproduction. This step helps to speed up the convergence in this algorithm, as we have a number of bacteria in the search space. Now how we can determine that which one is healthy bacteria and which one is not healthy bacteria? So the healthy status of any bacteria is calculated as the sum of step fitness during its lifetime. Here NC, here this represents the maximum step in the chemotaxis process. So we will store the bacteria in the reverse order according to their health status. And healthy bacteria means here in this algorithm, we will assume the bacteria with lower fitness value as the healthy bacteria, and the bacteria having the maximum value is considered as unhealthy bacteria. If fitness value is high, it means bacteria is unhealthy. If fitness value is low, it means bacteria is healthy. So in this step only, the first half of the population will survive and least healthy bacteria will eventually die. Now as you can see here, half of the population will survive. Now in order to keep the swarm size constant, here healthy bacteria split into two bacteria, that is the identical ones, and place in the same location. So it is simple. In the reproduction step, it will help algorithm to speed up the convergence. Here we will arrange the bacteria according to their health status. Lower the fitness value means healthy bacteria. Higher fitness value means unhealthy bacteria. We already stored the population in the reverse order, so only the half of the population will survive and the least healthy bacteria eventually die. And to keep the swarm size constant, we will split the healthy bacteria split into two bacteria, that is the identical one, and it are placed in the same location. Last step is elimination and dispersal. In order to prevent the local optima and for the global searching, now we will use elimination and dispersal. Dispersal event happen after a certain number of reproduction process, and we can choose some bacteria according to a preset of probability to be killed, or you can say eliminate. So in this algorithm, you can see the pseudocode for this algorithm. First, we will initialize all the important parameters that are used in this algorithm. For example, the dimensions that are used in the search space, dimension of the search space, total number of bacteria, that is the population size, and you can see a number of important parameters. After that, we will start in the step two, we will perform elimination dispersal loop. We will start the elimination dispersal loop for the bacteria elimination. We will start this loop. Here we will start this loop. And you can see here again in step 7, we have again this loop. So we will repeat this loop until stopping criteria is matched. In step 3, we will start the reproduction loop. Here we have chemotaxis loop. Inside this loop, we will perform certain actions. For example, we will take chemotactic step for the n number of bacteria. Here S is the swarm size, that is the total number of bacteria. After that, we will calculate the fitness function, and the value that you computed will store until you may find out the better one in each run. After that, thumble movement is performed, and for the randomness, here the normally distributed random values are used within the domain -1 and 1. Swarming process is performed. After that, we will go to the next bacteria by increment i+1. If I is not equal to the swarm size, then process the next bacteria. After that, we will check whether J is less than chemotactic step or not. Here J is the chemotaxis loop, So we will check this condition. If this condition is true, then we will continue the chemotaxis since the life of bacteria is not over. After that, we will perform the reproduction process and then elimination and dispersal. After that, we will check whether the elimination dispersal loop is less than elimination and dispersal steps. This is the stopping criteria. When this stopping criteria is matched, stop, else we will repeat the steps from step 2 to step 7. Once this stopping criteria is satisfied, stop and display result. So that's all about this video. Here the basic introduction about this algorithm is given. If you have any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.